The first demo I want to look at in this module is spidering. And spidering is the concept of crawling through a website, following all the links that exist in that site and creating a map of how it functions. So think about a spider web. And indeed, that's often an analogy for the internet itself. But think about it in the context of an individual website, where you start at one point and then there's a link to somewhere else, then to somewhere else and to somewhere else again. And when we talk about spidering, we're talking about crawling all of those links and building up a picture of how the site is put together. Now, this is one of the most fundamental principles in reconnaissance and footprinting, because it's really just following links on the site. It's not necessarily doing anything malicious. And certainly, there are a lot of tools that can spider a site, so crawl through it and then create a visual map of it. The tool that I've chosen to demo this is NetSparker. Now, I've used NetSparker before in a number of my other courses because I find it's a really, really easy to use dynamic analysis tool. So that is, you point it at a URL and you let it go. It doesn't just spider the site, it does a bunch of other things as well. But I'm just going to focus on the spidering component of it here. So let's do this. On the screen at the moment, you'll see the Start a New Scan dialog. And in the target website URL, you can see the hackyourselffirst.troyhunt.com address. Now, all I'm going to do is click on Start Scan. And now it is spidering. And we know it's spidering because down in the bottom left-hand corner in the dashboard panel, we can see it crawling. Now, even though this is quite a small site, the scan is going to take quite a while because what NetSparker is going to do is not just follow all the links that are actually explicitly referenced on the site, but also check a few other common ones as well. And you'll see what I mean by that when we have a look at the results. NetSparker also does a whole bunch of dynamic analysis. So that is, it actually tests for security vulnerabilities as it scans. Because it is going to take a while, we're going to let it run and then come back to this shortly. Okay, so NetSparker has now run. The whole process is complete. We've got a bunch of results here on the screen. We can see a nice set of traffic light color coding about critical and medium and all sorts of other ratings for vulnerabilities that's found on the site. What I want to focus on though is the sitemap off to the left of the screen. And this is really where the spidering has happened. So as we scroll down through this panel, what you'll see is literally a map of the site. We can see all the folders that are there in the site. We can also see things like the robots.txt. So this is the file that normally tells search engines what they can, and most importantly, cannot access and then index on the site. Now, robots files can be especially interesting. So let's go and have a look at this one just here. Now, over to the right of the screen, we can see a number of panels. The one at the top is the request panel. The one just below that is the response panel, and I'm particularly interested in what's come back in the response from that file. And in fact, if we scroll down a little bit, we can see the response headers, and then we can see the contents of the file. And these disallowed directives are particularly interesting. The disallowed directive on line 17 is really interesting because that's telling us that there is a path on this website called secret admin. Now that to me, with my attacker hat on, does sound rather attractive. Now because the robots.txt describes these resources on the site, NetSparker will crawl them. So what that means is if we now scroll back down through our sitemap, we will find the path called secret admin. So indeed, NetSparker has picked this up from the robots.txt and it's gone and crawled it. Now I'm particularly interested in the response, and I'll give us a little bit more room down here so we can see it all. Now as before, we can see all the response headers, and then as we start to scroll down, what we're going to see here is an HTML document. And in fact, we can see the title here says access denied. If I keep scrolling down though, as I get down towards the bottom of the page, we can see something particularly interesting on line 74. Download the database backup. Now this is obviously really useful information. I, as an attacker, would actually be rather interested in getting my hands on the database backup. And this is the sort of information that's very easy to discover by spidering the site. Now, obviously, this is a pretty basic example, and I've jumped straight to the really interesting parts of this. But there are many times that you'll look at a website and then look at the robots.txt and find it points to something particularly interesting, often somewhere that is not properly secured, that's been added to that file in order to keep it out of search engines, but then hasn't been properly secured because there's been the expectation that no one will find it because it won't be searchable. So that is a very simple example of what spidering does and what some of the information is you can discover by crawling through the website and picking up all of these different resources, some of which can be particularly interesting.